ladies and gentlemen. Gentlemen and ladies. Ladies and gents. Ladies and gentlemen, memories. We have the Manhattans. Climb aboard and relax.
Warm and satisfied.
All right. Could it be that it was all so simple then? Let me tell you all how simple it is. This is me adding Gibaru to Firefox. Now, what I will tell you, see, it's still verifying. What I will tell you is about Gibaru, and this is the unique thing about Gibaru, that Google Chrome has taken it out of its Google Chrome store. Ladies and gentlemen, why would Google Chrome, yes, I want to change my default search engine. Why would Google Chrome take Gibaru off its search engine? Well, because Gibaru gets rid of all that advertisement that Google does. Yes, I just said yes. Leave me alone now. All right. We're going to get off of this screen. Eventually, I'm going to come back to the Firefox. Now, the system I'm using is not actually Firefox. This is Waterfox.
Interesting that one is called Fire and the other one's called Water, huh? Waterfox.
Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, I need to take y'all someplace. Wait a minute. It's gone. Hold on. It's gone. No. Okay, I do want to add this. I'm sorry. I do want to add this.
Whoa. Yeah.
There is a problem, ladies and gentlemen. I had Case Text up, and Case Text is gone. We ain't playing that. C-A... Because there's something I want to show y'all. And it's this one right here. I didn't remove it. Lord have mercy. Could we? Would we? Memories. Ladies and gentlemen, memories. I remember when Barbara Streisand first sang this song, and I promise you, I didn't need no advertisement to make me appreciate this song right here, but the Manhattans did a very good job. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to pause the Manhattans right now, and we're going to do the majority of this without my background music. Those are my background singers. Ladies and gentlemen, gotta talk to you about something. A lot of you are trying to file documents in the court, and you're finding it really frustrating because you don't understand it. It's a different arena, a different world, a different environment. That is not your fault. It is designed that way to make it appear as if it's intimidating. So I'm going to tell you how to access the court. Now, here's the problem. You buck the system. You have to be prepared to fight for your right to party. I'm sorry, you have to be prepared to fight. That means you're going to have to appeal. And you don't appeal on the merits of your case. You appeal on the merits of process. That they denied you your right of process. Why? Because you have a right to access the court. Now remember, ignorance of the law.
There ain't no excuse for it. You cannot be ignorant of the law.
But there is no law requiring you to know the rules and procedures and formalities of the court. Just like you're not required to know the rules, procedures, and formalities of the administrative system. I want y'all to pay attention to this because some of y'all are not paying attention. The Administrative Procedures Act is not for you.
What?
The Administrative Procedures Act is not for you.
What?
I ain't gonna repeat myself again. Ladies and gentlemen, the Administrative Procedures Act is not for you. The Administrative Procedures Act is for the employees and individuals who are in the administrative arena. However, when you apply, when you subscribe, when you fill out them contracts with them administrative agencies, that's what the right to contract offering is all about. Go ahead. The cases you did not know it exists. It says that there must be a subscription. There must be a nexus. So when the police pull you over for a traffic infraction and you have a driver's license,
sorry, Charlie, you elected to be a part of that system and to receive the benefits of that.
Hold on now. Y'all still don't understand what's going on here. It's all about contract, people. So when you go into the court, they insist that you use their documents. You do not have to use their documents. You can take their documents and do what I do on PDF Exchange. And you can do an amended format. Just that simple. An amended format. Just that simple. You just put amended form. Because you're using their form, you're just amending the words. You don't have to contract with them, mother. I'm sorry, you don't have to contract with them, y'all. Now, wait. Have you heard the court say that your documents, your pleadings, were nonsensical, irrelevant, meritless, frivolous, or, pay attention, gobbledygook? Ladies and gentlemen, a judge cannot determine whether your pleadings are gobbledygook. By the way, you don't want to do pleadings because that means submitting to the court. So that's why you want to do petitions. You have the right to petition, not the right to plead.
I plead the Fifth Amendment, Your Honor.
Do not plead no Fifth Amendment.
I plead the Fifth Amendment.
There ain't no constitutional right for you to plead the Fifth Amendment.
You don't plead no Fifth Amendment. I'm exercising my right to speak and to remain silent. I am not offering up testimony. I don't have to offer up testimony. I am not under oath and do not wish or choose to be under oath at this time.
As anything you say can't be used against you, then I'm exercising that same equal protection of right. Now, move on with your business. I don't want to participate in your investigation. Okay, by the way, once you ask for counsel, anything you say after that is inadmissible. See, if you continue to speak, that doesn't mean you waived your right to counsel. Oh, please, no. You got the right to speak. It's just anything concerning this matter. I want counsel present. Other than that, I'm going to talk and talk and talk, and the police are going to still try to use it against you. Now you get to bring it in court. Now you get to put that before a jury. Either I have the right to say whatever I want to say, or I don't. Then you bring up the fact that a police officer, like I did in the last two videos, talking about how police officers can lie.
I know you used the word L-Y-E. It ain't L-Y-E. Yes, it is. It is lie. You know how lying can burn you? That's right. Talk to any cosmetologist. They'll tell you how lie can burn you. So when you tell a lie, you gonna get burned.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, if the police can lie, doesn't mean you can. Okay, because the God I serve, he says he hates liars. He hates a false tongue. So don't play that game. Say, I was not under oath. I did not take an oath to tell the truth at that moment. If that was the case, then while I'm standing here, why do they have me take an oath? No, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, why do they have me, when I walk into this building, take an oath if anything I say can be used against me? There is no law saying anything I say can be used against me. Unless I am specifically under oath, that's not reliable. And it is hearsay. Just because a police officer said he heard it doesn't make it true. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, you guys got to understand, as long as police can lie, then Do you understand why I asked the officer, have you ever lied before? That's why. Because they get to lie on the witness stand. They get to lie. I've witnessed them lying, documented their lying, called them on their lies. Well, ladies and gentlemen, if they lie, that means that you've been denied the right to a fair trial. Because it isn't fair for them to lie and for you not to lie. It isn't fair for you to take an oath to tell the truth, and a police officer gets up there and he swears to tell the truth, and then he lies and can't be prosecuted for lying. But if you lie on a witness stand, you can be prosecuted for perjury. Interesting, ain't it? Somebody got to purge that jury. Hey, get that purge jury out of here. All right, let me go ahead and explain to you guys when you're petitioning the court. What the real rule is. Now, this is a child custody battle. So, you know, these are some pro se litigants. The allegations of the petition must be sufficiently clear. So you ain't got to be all lawyerly. You just say, hey, this mother came to my house, slapped my child in the face. And so I pulled out my 9 and I lit that mother up. Okay, sorry. Hey, I'm just saying, you just got to explain what happened. The defendant, that a person of average intelligence would know what was intended. Oh, look right there, jury. It says lawsuit. I'm suing these mother. That's what this is about. No, this ain't about me being technical. This is me saying this mother came into my house and slapped my child in the face. He was trespassing. He ain't had no authority to come in my house and slap my child. Only I get to slap my child. And in the face, too? I don't even slap my child in the face. You follow me?
You know, that's not a very good analogy.
Okay, let's do another one. I do a lawsuit, and I say I went to Brown and Green Chevrolet, and I purchased a 2021 Lamborghini, and I gave them a money order that said item of credit. They took the money order and gave me the keys to the car. On that money order, it said, this item is backed by full faith and credit. You are to deposit this with the United States Treasury to receive the credit. Ladies and gentlemen, they write that off as a bad debt. They get credit from the government 6 months later. That is an even exchange. Shh, don't tell nobody. I'm not saying go out there and do that. I'm saying I'm putting together a lawsuit. Later, this actually happened, people, not a Lamborghini, but this actually happened. They sent the police to my house. The police! To repossess the car. Jury, the police don't have any repossessing capabilities. There was no warrant. If there is no warrant, the police have no jurisdiction to come onto private property and seize a vehicle that doesn't belong to them. That is illegal. That's what my lawsuit is about. They violated my rights. They trespassed upon my rights. That's what my lawsuit is about. They had no authority. Now, if you want me to go into detail, I will explain to you about how in Gonzalez versus Castle Rock Police Department, how the Supreme Court said that I have no contract with the police department. And unless they can prove that I have a contract with them, they had no authority to take my automobile. Ladies and gentlemen, that is sufficiently clear and definite that a person of average intelligence would know what you were intending to do, file a lawsuit. Now, what they say is you must tell the court what you want. Oh, I want my money back. I want my car back. And I want them to pay for what they did. So I'm suing them in every capacity for which they purported to operate. That way you sue them in their personal capacity, their official capacity, their legal capacity, their discapacity, their uncapacity, their miscapacity,
and their risk capacity. You know what I'm saying?
And because they worked for the city, the city is not immune because the city authorized these officers. They did it under color and authority of law. The Civil Rights Act of 1866, which applies to every single gender, race, color, creed in the nation, the Civil Rights Act of 1866 says, I have rights. And when they act under color and or authority of law, then they're acting without jurisdiction. And as long as they're acting without jurisdiction, that means they have no immunity. Because immunity only covers them in their official capacity. It does not cover them in their personal capacity. I am also suing them in their personal capacity. They have no immunity in that capacity. They must prove that they were acting in their official capacity and that they have an oath of office and they were abiding by their oath of office. If they were not abiding by their oath of office, that means they're in violation of their oath of office. That means they are guilty of perjury. Because you take an oath, you make a promise. They have violated their promise. They have breached the public trust. Ladies and gentlemen, I promise you, I've given you every argument you can bring against officials, whether they be judges or anybody else. Judges or anybody else have an obligation to protect the public interest. You, as a member of the public, your interest is in line with the public. They are synonymous. They are harmoniously joined, linked, cannot be severed. These individuals try to disenfranchise you, take away your right to be a member of the public. It's okay to be John Q. Public. By the way, some of y'all are going to do this because some of y'all are honoring. Police pull you over? License and registration, I'm sorry? License and registration. Got no license and no registration. What you mean license and registration? Why are you asking me for a license and registration?
Well, you need a blah, blah, blah.
Oh, I'm sorry. My name is John Q. I'm part of the public. The Supreme Court recognizes who I am. Or my name is Jane Doe. Yep, Supreme Court and the regular courts know who I am. Man, I got so many cases. What, y'all don't know about that abortion case? Y'all don't know about the abortion case where the person is called Doe? D-O-E? Or somebody who files a lawsuit and put, comma, Doe's 1 through 185 billion, etc. all? Y'all don't know about Doe? Everybody can be a Doe. Can't nobody stop you from being a Doe. Now, like I said, some of y'all are going to play with that, but that is given to the people who know what they're doing. They'll understand what to do with the Doe thing and when they're dealing with certain authorities. Okay, you are allowed to be a Doe. Doe Ray Me, you can be a deer. Oh, you're such a deer. Oh, you're such a deer. Oh, he's a sweetheart, isn't he? Oh, he's oh dear. That's what a doe is, ladies and gentlemen. A deer. D for deer, a female deer. Doe. I'm sorry. Doe Ray Me Fa So La Ti. Doe is a deer, ladies and gentlemen.
You're such a deer.
So you can be a doe any day of the week.
Oh, you are a dear, 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 sweet little boy. You're such a dear. Now, get on over there and clean up that room. That's what some of your mamas used to say to you.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, now that you are understanding a little bit about the technicalities of the system, the technicalities of the courts, if as long as what you have stated is simple and plain, you don't have to get technical. You don't have to cover all the bases. That's the problem. Oh, by the way, this is a 1978 case. So all you got to do is put this in case text and pull up these cases. If any, this is a 1921 case. Hold on. 1921. Let's find out.
This is the fireman's pension.
A pleading is sufficient if it is intelligible to a person of ordinary understanding. Judges don't have ordinary understanding. Judges cannot rely on their own understanding. They're incompetent to rely on their own understanding. So a judge cannot tell you that your so-called petition is unintelligible, is nonsensical. Words don't even exist in English. Okay? Unintelligible is not an English word. Intelligible is not an English word. These are words they created.
Okay, let's go ahead. If it is intelligible to a person of ordinary understanding and affords him, the court, and the jury a means of determining what is intended. I'm intending to sue these mother... That's what's intended. I want my money. I want my car back. That's what I put in there. That's what's intended. If you ain't getting that from that, then that means that you don't have an ordinary understanding, which means you are incompetent to hear this matter. Just that simple. Hold on. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been here all this time. Many of you didn't know this. You are all worried. You are all writing all these documents and putting all this junk in it. Stop putting all that junk in your stuff.
Oh, man, she's got so much junk in her stuff.
Okay, stop putting all that junk in your stuff, people. That junk in your stuff is nothing but extra added flesh. They call that obesity. So get that junk out of your stuff, okay? Stop making your petitions obese. Got to go through so much just to get to the point, which is what they are claiming is nonsensical, unintelligible. Any common, ordinary person would be getting to the point. This person is going all around the corner. All around the world the same.
The late Shock G.
A pleading is not required to be in any particular form. A pleading is not required to be in any particular form. A pleading is not required to be in any particular form, but it must be so expressed as to enable a person of common understanding, common law
understanding, to know what is intended. Did y'all see that? Did y'all see that? It says it must be
as a, this is a California case. No, it ain't. This is New York. Whoo, I'm sorry. That's usually how California does this case. It's civil code, blah, blah, blah. By the way, codes ain't law. Okay? Codes ain't law. Now, here's another one.
Here goes another one. I know you're going to dig this.
Give me 1 second.
The notice should be drafted in such a manner as to make it understandable by the people to whom it is directed.
Aw, did you see it said by the people to whom it is directed? This is the Federal Rules of Civil Procedure. Aw, that is so special that they say by the people to whom it is directed. No, by the common people, ladies and gentlemen. Not by somebody who went to some stupid school and think they know more than you. That ain't how this works.
If the language of a complaint enables a person of common understanding to know what is intended, it is sufficient.
There you go, people. That's what you rely on.
A pleading need only convey enough information that a defendant is able to understand
the gravamen
of the complaint. Whomever you're suing.
This says it just needs to have enough information to say, hey, you mother did me wrong.
This is what you're going to rely on, ladies and gentlemen. I was listening to, I was on
Bright EeoN.
Oh man, that boy's so bright.
I was listening to an audio on Bright EeoN. Someone did an audio on the courts. And they were talking about accessing the court and having some problems. And he called up this guy, and I forgot the guy's name.
And the guy was talking about how he went over all these rules and all these books and studied all this stuff. And he's had some success.
Ladies and gentlemen, I promise you, if you go over all those rules and all of those books, you'll be just like the lawyers. You'll have some success. But what I'm saying is you don't need to go over all those rules, all those books, and all that junk, because that's nonsensical. Ladies and gentlemen, pay attention. It is nonsensical for your pleadings to convey more than enough information that anybody of ordinary understanding would not understand it.
Using all of that junk, all of these papers, all of these documents, enough. I'm just doing an appeal. You guys want all that other stuff? Go get it from the court. They are the record keepers. I am not certifying that record. I am not consenting to that record. That is not the record. The record is this. They denied me due process. I don't need to have what they've recorded because I'm not sanctioning that. Those people don't work for me.
The clerk of the court is not even an officer of the court. They are part of the administrative branch. Pay attention. The clerk of the court is part of the administrative branch of government. Yet they are blocking my access to the court.
So, let's continue. Yes, I'm sorry. If you guys don't realize how many of these judges and attorneys listen to these videos, some of them, they only listen to portions, but some of them listen to everything. Why? Because what I'm telling you, they're looking for loopholes to help them on their end. See, because all I'm doing is putting holes in what they do. And so they're looking for ways to try to fill those holes after what I say to you, because they know some of you are going to listen. I've got too many people contacting me, telling me,
you know, the information you've given me, I've had so much success. I've been able to do this and been able to do that.
I understand, people. Ladies and gentlemen, there's a young man, Don, kill him! I'm going to give the young man some credit because he did me some justice. He said I did him some justice, then he did me some justice. You know what? Let's do this. We're going to three finger.
Mama, he gave me three fingers.
Come on now, give him my three fingers. And we're going to duplicate. I ain't going to do no private.
You're my private dancer.
That's that woman. Come on now, where it is? What it is? What it be like? What it be like? What the? Okay. Oh, YouTube. We're going to YouTube.
We are going to YouTube. We are going to YouTube. Oh, I want to get on the biggest ride they got there. We're going to YouTube, y'all. That's what they're getting me for that day that they call the 25th of December, where they worship the sun god, and winter solstice on January 6th. They call it All Saints Day, or no, All Kings Day, or the Three Kings Day, or the 18 Kings Day. Oh, Lord.
Sorry. You guys know how much I love December 25th, how it is probably the most important day in human history. That's right, because it's the day of the biggest lie ever told in man's history.
No, that's not the biggest lie. No, let me tell you what the biggest lie was.
No, December 25th is the biggest lie ever told. Why? Because it's the longest spreading lie out there. The longest one. Ladies and gentlemen, December 25th, everybody and their grandmama know that Jesus was not born on no December 25th. Everybody knows it, and yet they still celebrate it. Do you not understand? Then they teach their kids to lie, believing in some stupid idiot and some red little, I don't understand y'all. Why? Do you know if you promote a lie, you yourself become that lie? That means you're not trusting. No one can trust you. Stop promoting a lie. People say, well, you shouldn't be saying stuff like that on this day. Why? Everybody knows it's a joke. Everybody knows that December 25th is only for commerce. Christmas trees and putting gifts underneath. What the? Come on, people. What is wrong with you guys? Don. K-I-L-L-A-M. Don Killam. I don't want to do Don Killam YouTube. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to let you know that Mr. Killam, I've spoken with the young man, and I am... What I want to let you know, if you go to our website, we have an ID that was there from 2012 that I did. I did a video late 2011, early 2012, told you guys we were going to do the non-citizen national ID. And I put the picture up there and I sent it out and told everybody, and I actually laminated mine. Where's your... Don, where is your ID? Well, look at this. How to get diplomatic immunity. I like that. I don't know. Everything that Don talks about, look, I can't tell you. What I can tell you is the information Don gives on the let's go to his page. The information Don gives on the... Where is... There it is. That's what I'm looking for. The information he gives on his website. And I don't see his website. So give me a second. Where's your website, Don? Where's the ID? I don't see the ID. But he does talk about getting on airplanes, checking in the motels and everything, and I understand why that works. So I've ordered the ID, and he sent me, before mailing it to me, he sent me a copy of what he was doing. And let's do hyphen non C I T I Z E N. N-A-T-I-O-N-A-L, non-citizen national. Ladies and gentlemen, the term non-citizen national comes actually from a stupid little code that they put together. Explain how he acquired a free cannabis using the non-citizen national, and he's at nationalitytravels.com. Ladies and gentlemen, that's where I went. I told the young man that I was going to do a video and send you guys there. Now, look, hold on. Hold on, Don Kalam. Give me 1 second.
Peace and love to the world.
Ladies and gentlemen, what I want to tell you...
Peace, love, positive energy to the guys.
Y'all can't be talking while I'm talking. Come on, that's disrespectful. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to go to this website right here, nationalitytravels.com. Okay, again, I am not telling you that this is going to put you on a plane, train, or automobile to Freedomville. No, what I'm telling you is... What this will do for you is when you are needing a secondary ID, this will provide that secondary ID. Pay attention. Everybody wants to talk about a governmental ID. There is no such thing as a governmental ID. There is no such thing as a governmental ID. All of the governmental agencies are themselves private corporations. If you look at their CAFRs, Comprehensive Annual Financial Reports, conclusive of notes, references, term definitions, and ledgers, you will see that they are privately owned corporations. The DMV, Mr. Rod Class, has already proven that the DMV is not government. Okay, so this is the nationality website. This is where you can go on here. And you know what? He is busy, but he has communicated back with me. I don't know about everybody else's and their grandmama's experiences. I don't care. I'm letting you know about mine. My experience with this young man is he has been honorable the entire time. And respectful. I kid you not. More than respectful. Okay?
This is now on Amazon. For $5.
The study guide to nationality travels, and it's only $5. I haven't gone over that. I've seen the video right here about him checking into a hotel with the ID. This is the way the ID looks, ladies and gentlemen. Now, you're going to have a lot of haters. The unique thing about his ID is it's not expensive. Do you guys understand that other IDs similar to this are expensive? The world passport, that thing cost me quite a bit. The world passport cost me quite a bit. Now, the one thing that drew me to his site was this right here. Okay, for some of you who are taking your automobiles off the rolls, okay, pay attention. When you take your automobile off the rolls and pay attention and you get your automobile classified as non-operating, Remember, they get you because you are operating a motor vehicle. So you need what's known as a non-operating permit. It simply says on the non-operating permit, this is not a permit to drive. Well, I'm not looking for permission. I just had the county that I live in tell me that I need their permission to get a street address. Told them, I don't need your permission for nothing. I don't have a contract with you. Ladies and gentlemen, I purchased my property. I didn't register my property with the county. I had the post office tell me, we check with the county, and your property is not even registered with them. You better believe my property is not registered with the county. This is my property. I don't have to register my property with the county. Why? Because it's my property. It's mine. I ain't got to register my property. Hold on now. Many of you are not going to be able to handle that. Oh, by the way, if you get this one, the one that's 139, well, 140, if you get this one, you get the plate and the ID combination. Okay? Two for the price of one. This is the one I received. Okay? This is the one I received. And I can handle this one, y'all. I promise you I can handle this one. I promise you I can handle this one. Just that simple. Now, I am not telling you that this will work for you. Take it as a novelty thing. You're hearing me say it. Okay, take it as a novelty thing, but you must understand that I told you when I was in Puerto Rico, sorry, the two officers, when I handed them my ID, they didn't know what to do. That you should have seen them looking at each other. One looked at the other one, they just looked at each other. Sorry, that was hilarious. If all of you could have been there, because I'm just standing there looking at them, because all I'm doing is walking, and they pulled me over. I was walking, and they pulled me over. Okay, because you're not allowed to walk in this country. Puerto Rico is part of the United States. For those of you who didn't know, many people think Puerto Rico is a foreign country, foreign island. No, Puerto Rico is part of the United States, people. Anyway, I was walking and they pulled me over. Have you ever been walking and the police pull you over? Ladies and gentlemen, you have the right to walk. You have the right to travel. The police don't get to pull you over because they suspected something. No, you have to have much greater than a suspicion to trample on my right. So you better come at me with a little bit more than I fit a description. You better bring me a description. Why y'all keep talking while I'm talking?
Word to the world.
Stop that!
Peace, love, positive energy to the gods and goddesses. Man.
Now, I, gods and goddesses? Ladies and gentlemen, the god I serve, he doesn't approve of them gods.
I was at the dispensary, man.
Why are you still talking? Sorry, let me turn this off. It is the voice. It is the voice recognition that's the problem. Okay, I believe I solved that problem. The unique thing about the non-citizen national ID, ladies and gentlemen, the reason why the ID does work, even with this real ID thing that's coming up, the real ID is only for international travels and that type of stuff. Get that junk out of here. Okay. The voice recognition came back on its own. And so give me a second to turn it back off, because that's the problem. What you guys, many of you, Eric Schroden or whatever his name is, Edward. Yeah, whatever the young man's name is. Sorry, I can't think about it right now. Too much on my mind. I got work to do, and I've been delaying the work that I need to do, and I got to get it done. See, it's still listening. this is what I want you guys to know. You have your cell phones, and this thing right here is still moving. Okay? That's the voice recognition thing. And so what I'm going to do is put that right there so that it can't type anything in that field while I'm talking.
Bro gay.
Look at that.
Nationality travelers.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I shut down the voice recognition until I start doing my work. That's the first thing. The second thing I need to let you guys know, because it's important, I put in Rod Class, DMV is not government, and I didn't pull up what I wanted to pull up because Rod Class went to court in D.C. and actually proved the Department of Motor Vehicles is not government. Now, his videos are still up. In 2000, no, I didn't ask you to go here. Stop it. Sorry. It's the Mac, so it's very sensitive, the keypad. Since 2012, because I hadn't done any checking up on Mr. Class to see what was going on with Mr. Class, apparently there is a guilty verdict someplace. This is what Rod Class did with the Supreme Court. He pled guilty to something. And in a majority of the opinion, Stephen Breyer, now retired, a guilty plea alone does not bar a federal criminal defendant from challenging the constitutionality of a statute. Okay? Y'all gonna need that when we talk about your right to challenge the constitutionality of a statute.
A guilty plea alone in itself does not bar a federal criminal defendant, blah, blah, blah.
So I'm going to look up. I've been wondering why I hadn't heard much from Rod. Rod Class has gotten to the Supreme Court. Man, I give this man some credit because he's gotten to the Supreme Court several times. And he's got several pretty good victories underneath his belt. Rod Class, y'all. These are the type of people you'll see me giving credit to because they prove it. Now, this case went in 2017, so that means in 2012 when they were coming after me, they were going after the others. I told you it looked like I was the last one of that so-called guru pack that they went after, and I called myself a junior guru. Okay, especially when it came to YouTube. But, ladies and gentlemen, yeah, I do hope that Rod is doing all right, and the fact that he ended up going back into court and challenging the statute, okay? And it says that he can challenge the statute, the constitutionality of a statute, on direct appeal. Ladies and gentlemen, if he can do it in a criminal matter, he can do it in a civil matter. So I'm going to click on this because I need this, because I'm challenging statutes on appeal. I've been doing that from the very beginning. They have been trying to deny me and block me. And now it's time to go to the appeals court. I was looking for the DMV thing, but it ain't pulling up. But I do know that he did go to the DMV. You know what? I could be wrong. I believe it was Rod Class. It could have been Patrick, but I believe it was Rod. Okay? I believe it was Rod, not Patrick. Patrick did his stuff, too. You know what I'm saying? But Rod did his stuff. That's how I know about the cases. Didn't know about this one, okay? Because this one happened after they came after me. The second time? Puerto Rico was the second time. Okay, they had already done it in 2005. Took 45 days of my life away. Thought it was going to be okay. That's why I did the arbitrations. Those of you who don't understand arbitration and the contracts, I will do a video right after this explaining arbitration and the contracts so that you guys will get this. Now, this video is simply going to be entitled what it was about. So we started this video talking about how to access the court the simple way. And all you got to do is do a simple pleading. Then we talked about the non-citizen national ID. So we're going to stop here. I'm going to do the Rod Class thing later, but we're going to stop here and let you guys know, hey, what's up? Where my water? This ain't the frozen video. Where my water at? Who let the water? Oh, I'm sorry. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, so that all of you know, I will be, as you've seen today and as you've seen in the past, decreasing the music simply not because of you,
but because right now I'm in a different mood. I went to the doctor, to a chiropractor yesterday. Man, after he did his, it only lasted for 5 hours, but after he did his little manipulation with that little device, it's a little simple device. He just tapped in areas, and next thing you know, I'm standing straight up looking above him, okay? He is almost the same height as me, but I'm looking way over his head because I'm now standing straight without having to make myself stand straight.
I'm not hunched over like I'm 58,000 years old. That's not how it is, okay?
And so I told him, you have no idea how much better I feel. I've been finding out the reason why I've been yelling at people is because I've been in so much pain. Like right now, I'm in pain, and it is my back. It is the mattress I'm laying on. I'm about to correct that sometime next week, but for right now, I'll deal with it. But it is the amount of pain that I'm in.
Oh, you must be in a lot of pain because you're always yelling.
Mm-hmm. Ladies and gentlemen, it is a lot of pain because muscular dystrophy in and of itself comes with a lot of pain. Okay? That is just the fact. It comes with a lot of pain. And so I have to endure. Come on, tell him. Gotta go, y'all. Y'all take care of yourselves. That's the way you end the video. Thank you, Manhattans. Thank you. Gotta go.